even if you fail to the very depth, there's a preacher, Billy Graham, you're a preacher, not a street preacher, but one of these televangelists, he fell into sin, sexual sin, money sin, he fell into big sin. And everybody cut this preacher off, cut him off, wouldn't talk to him anymore. You're a goner, you've sinned, that's it, forget you, you failed, end of story, end of your life. And the guy was in prison. Nobody saw him, nobody go see him, nobody cared about him. You was a big time minister, but now you've fallen into a sexual sin. Now you've fallen, that's it, end of story. Billy Graham went to see him. What did Billy Graham do? Billy Graham just put his arm around him and showed him love.
Amen.
Everybody can be forgiven, no matter how deep the sin is, if we truly repent. 1 John chapter 1 verse 9, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. He will forgive you.
Amen.
Isaiah 43:25, I am he who blots out your transgressions and remembers them no more. So anybody here who's failed, you failed in some way, and you keep beating yourself up with that sin, you've done it, and you failed, and you keep beating yourself up with it, you need to stop beating yourself up. You're forgiven today.
Amen.
If you come to the cross. Ephesians 1:7. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, in accordance with the riches of his grace. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins. Your sins are forgiven today through his blood and the riches of his grace. So we've come to the end today. If you go for a mortgage, and you go for a mortgage and you fill in the form, if you lie on that mortgage form, chances are you're going to get found out. Well, so let's say your income's £20,000 a year, and you go, my income's £60,000 a year, and you're lying just to get the mortgage, they're going to find out. They're going to do a credit check on you, they're going to find out. We cannot hide our sin. It'll come out in the wash somewhere along the line. Somewhere along the line, if you sin, secret sin will come out somewhere. Especially sexual sin, it will come out somewhere in the wash. Somewhere. But if we fail and if we do sin, if we truly repent, God is merciful. And God is good. Psalm 103, verse 12. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he removed our transgression from us. Never let anybody condemn you or point the finger at you when you've truly repented and ask for forgiveness.
Amen.
Don't let anybody drag the past up to you. If you've truly repented, it's gone. It's washed. And very often, sometimes when you're honest with people, they drag up your past. When you're honest with people, they put you down. But it's better to be honest and honest with God and honest with people. But if you're honest with yourself and with God, he will forgive you.
Amen.
And nobody can put you down.
Amen.
So repent. We all need to repent. It's all about God's glory at the end of the day.
Amen.
It's all about him. And the more we meditate on who God is, the more we think about God and how great he is, the more we'll hate sin, and the more we'll turn away from sin, and the more we'll pursue God. And we sin because we take our eyes off God, and we take our eyes off the battle. And then we get into a mess. So look to Jesus. Look to the Lord. Have fire in your bones for him. And keep being passionate about Jesus every day.
Amen.
And you'll avoid sin. God bless you. Thank you. Amen. Thank you. God bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Glory to God. So we are worshiping, we can stand in front of God amazed.
Amen.
Forgiven. Amen.
Amen.
No.
You want to dance now? Fire all around. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Now yes. Okay. We are worshiping.